Welcome to the prayer channel. The ways of life and the ways of death. Some decisions we make lead to life and others lead to destruction and death. As we read Proverbs 14, Lord, we just ask that you would set us on your perfect and right path. Proverbs 14 reads, "The wise woman builds her house, but the foolish pulls it down with her hands. He who walks in his uprightness fears the Lord, but he who is perverse in his ways despises him. In the mouth of a fool is a rod of pride, but the lips of the wise will preserve them. Where no oxen are, the trough is clean, but much increase comes by the strength of an ox. A faithful witness does not lie, but a false witness will utter lies. A scoffer seeks wisdom and does not find it, but knowledge is easy to him who understands. Go from the presence of a foolish man when you do not perceive in him the lips of knowledge. The wisdom of the prudent is to understand his way, but the folly of fools is deceit. Fools mock at sin, but among the upright there is favour. The heart knows its own bitterness, and a stranger does not share its joy. The house of the wicked will be overthrown, but the tent of the upright will flourish. There is a way that seems right to a man, but its way is the way of death. Even in laughter the heart may sorrow, and the end of mirth may be grief. The backslider in heart will be filled with his own ways, but a good man will be satisfied from above. The simple believes every word, but the prudent considers well his steps. A wise man fears and departs from evil, but a fool rages and is self-confident. A quick-tempered man acts foolishly, and a man of wicked intentions is hated. The simple inherit folly, but the prudent are crowned with knowledge. The evil will bow before the good, and the wicked at the gates of the righteous. The poor man is hated even by his own neighbour, but the rich man has many friends. He who despises his neighbour sins, but he who has mercy on the poor, happy is he. Do they not go astray who devise evil? But mercy and truth belong to those who devise good. In all labour there is profit, but idle chatter leads only to poverty. The crown of the wise is their riches, but the foolishness of fools is folly. A true witness delivers souls, but a deceitful witness speaks lies. In the fear of the Lord there is strong confidence, and his children will have a place of refuge. The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life, to turn one away from the snares of death. In a multitude of people is a king's honour, but in the lack of people is the downfall of a prince. He who is slow to wrath has great understanding, but he who is impulsive exalts folly. A sound heart is life to the body, but envy is rottenness to the bones. He who oppresses the poor reproaches his maker, but he who honours him has mercy on the needy. The wicked is banished in his wickedness, but the righteous has a refuge in his death. Wisdom rests in the heart of him who has understanding, but what is in the heart of fools is made known. Righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. The king's favour is toward a wise servant, but his wrath is against him who causes shame." Lord, would we be those who never tear down our houses, Lord? Would we be those that build up our house and others around us, Lord? Lord, would you bless our hands and our feet, Lord, to tread upon the ground that you've called us to take for you, Lord. Would you make our hands work for your purposes, Lord? Lord, we ask that you would cleanse us, Lord, from all unrighteousness, Lord, and keep us away from perverseness and wickedness and lies. Lord, we are crying out for your presence. We're crying out for just more of you in every way, Lord. Lord, we are looking for the wisdom that only you have. The wisdom that only you have. And Lord, we're finding it in this book of Proverbs. As we read through daily, Lord, there is more knowledge that is going deep into our hearts. And Lord, where the enemy says, why are you spending time reading or praying? that it's not of any value. Lord, we thank you that you have destroyed the works of darkness and you have declared your great light, Lord, who is your Son, Jesus Christ, who came to the earth for our salvation. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that you said, seek and you will find, knock and the door will be opened. And Lord, that's what we're doing daily as we come to you. We thank you, Lord, that we're seeking you. And Lord, you said that you are a rewarder of those who diligently seek you. And so, Lord, as we diligently seek you daily, we thank you, Lord, that we will be rewarded with your favor, with your presence, and with your peace. Lord, we desire to live good lives. We desire to enjoy happiness, Lord. Lord, we enjoy all the things that you have, and we want to enjoy them even more. So, Lord, help us. Calm our hearts. Help us to be simple and appreciative of what we have. Lord, we're truly grateful for all you are and all you have done. Lord, you teach us here, Lord, that wickedness never, ever flourishes. It never works out. The bad way never works out. The wrong way never works out. Lord, where we can see that, would you help others around us, Lord, to see the light that only you can provide, to make decisions, Lord, for their lives, Lord, that are going to transform their futures. Would you give us those words of wisdom to speak to those, Lord, who are around us, who are struggling, who are just drenched in sin, going the wrong way and have no understanding or no idea. And Lord, when we speak to them, they don't even seem to hear. Lord, we understand that the God of this age has blinded them, but Lord, we pray that you would lift the veil of darkness and deception over those we are around. Lord, as Christians, as your children, Lord, we are light bearers, Lord, and we are called to shine light in the darkness. So Lord, in every area that we have, every area that we live in, Lord, help us to shine light into the darkness. Lord, we give you thanks for this day. We give you thanks for our lives, Lord. And even as we pray and bring forward those who we are praying for over the next few minutes, Lord. Lord, would you supernaturally touch the lives of those that we are petitioning you for today. Lord, would you reveal your great light to them and give them your wisdom and increase ours too. In Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen. Thank you.